Hey guys, Greg Alexander again today. And today I want to take the mystery out of which line to use in which situations for bass fishing. And I want to start by just defining the three types of line, which most of you guys know, but just for the sake of argument, fluorocarbon, braided line, and monofilament, and combinations of those lines are very important in certain situations. So let's start first with braid to fluorocarbon. When I say braid to fluorocarbon, I'm talking about you spool your reel up with braid almost to the end, and then you put a length of fluorocarbon leader on it, various lengths. Generally, I would use about three full arm lengths for a leader length of fluorocarbon. And most of the time, I'm only going to use a fluorocarbon leader and braided line on a spinning rod. I would personally very rarely use a fluorocarbon leader on a braided line bait casting. Very rarely would I ever do that. There are some situations where it may be applicable, but that's not something you need to do. So, fluorocarbon leader, braid main line is critical to fish when you are drop shotting. And why do I say that? Can you fish with straight fluorocarbon? You can fish with straight fluorocarbon. But if you fish with straight fluorocarbon drop shotting and you're reeling up a lot and dropping, reeling up a lot and dropping, what tends to happen is when you reel it up, your bait on that drop shot rig tends to helicopter up. What's that do? Cause line twist. And then usually by the end of the day, you got a mess on your hands. So you want to go with drop shot, I would say 100% of the time with a drop shot, use a braided main line to a fluorocarbon leader, depending on how deep you want to get. Which weight you're using would depend on what size fluorocarbon and what size braid. My typical drop shot setup is going to be 10-pound braid and 8-pound or possibly 6-pound fluorocarbon if I'm throwing something really small. So another time you would use braid to a fluorocarbon leader is when you need to make long casts, because that braided line is going to give you an ability to make a longer cast than the fluorocarbon is, as long as you're not skipping, which we'll talk about. And that long cast with that braid, not only can you make a longer cast with it, it has zero stretch, so you can take up the line better on the hook set. Fluorocarbon has very little stretch, but it does have some. So when you connect braid to fluorocarbon, there's multiple knots that you can use. Personally, I use the uni knot. You can use an Albright knot, you can use an FG knot, you can use a San Diego Jam knot, and there's a whole assortment of knots. And you can look up on YouTube how to tie all these knots. There's several people that get pieces of rope, that you can see cleanly, and they tie these knots for you so you can learn how to do them. I personally like the uni knot. I think it's the hardest one to mess up. Some of these knots you can mess up. If you don't tie it just right, you can mess up and they'll pull out. The uni knot, man, it's just almost indestructible. So that would be my recommendation. So a third time you would use braid to fluorocarbon would be when you just have a hard time really feeling the bite, and maybe you're flipping and you got heavier line, but the water's still kind of clear, so you don't want just straight braid. Or the water's clear and you don't want straight braid, because straight braid flipping sometimes it has like so much stiff, or it has so little stretch to it that it's really hard sometimes to keep from getting hung up throwing straight braid, because it doesn't give you any stretch at all to like working over branches and things like that. But you have a hard time feeling with monofilament or hard time feeling with straight fluorocarbon. So you put some heavy braid on there and it just gives you a little bit more of a sensation of knowing that you're getting a bite. The next line setup that you could use would be straight braid. Now straight braid, anytime you're flipping or pitching heavy vegetation, straight braid is the way to go. It cuts the vegetation, whereas monofilament or fluorocarbon will bog down in the vegetation, wrap around lily pads, and the fish will get off, whereas the braid will actually cut right through that, and you'll catch that fish sometimes. Now, there's some times when you're flipping heavy vegetation, and man, these fish are just getting hammered by pressure, and you may go to a heavy fluorocarbon instead of the straight braid, just because that braid, it kind of sings when you drop it in the water and it goes down between that vegetation. It'll kind of make a little singing sound. And I think sometimes these fish get conditioned to that. So sometimes you may have to change back to, you know, maybe straight fluorocarbon in those situations. But straight braid cuts the vegetation. Straight braid, I would always use straight braid on a buzzbait. I would always use straight braid on ploppers and topwater frogs or toads, always. No stretch, get it anywhere, gives you the upper hand on the fish. You're throwing one hook bait sometimes or a double hook bait when it comes to frogs and toads. And it just gives you all the power that you need to get it done, and you don't have to worry about your line breaking or anything. Another time I would throw straight braid would be if you're a co-angler in a tournament and you want to be able to pull your baits off without breaking them off all day. Sometimes co-anglers just tie straight braid on there so they don't, you know, worry their angler to death. I'm hung up. They can just pull it off. Throw straight braid on square bills, vibrating jigs, spinner baits. Anytime you're dealing with dirty, dirty water, barnacles, or extremely heavy cover, that you need instant power to get the fish out. So the next combination is not a combination, but monofilament. Old tried and true monofilament. Why would you use monofilament? Who uses monofilament? A lot of people use monofilament, but monofilament is best in these situations. Crankbaits, because you get that stretch that you need sometimes to keep the fish from pulling off. Topwater poppers, not ploppers, but poppers. And why do I say poppers but not ploppers? Well, ploppers, you're throwing out there and you're just kind of reeling it back in, okay? A popper, you're throwing it out there and you're popping it and stopping it and popping it and stopping it. Well, if you were to throw braid in those situations, you're really going to get frustrated because that plopper is going to pop and the line's going to stop and it's going to float and it's going to hook that braid because that braid is so soft sometimes it kind of loops back on the plopper and you end up with the braid in the hooks all the time with ploppers and prop baits and walking baits, baits that tend to, you know, you're not just bringing them straight in. So that monofilament, you know, it's a little bit more rigid than the braid and it, you know, it tends to float and not sink. That's why you wouldn't use fluorocarbon. And it tends to stay out of those hooks and not cause you the frustration. So you could throw braid, you can throw braid to monofilament also in those situations where you're throwing ploppers, poppers, prop baits, and walking baits where you need to get that longer cast again. But if you throw straight braid, it's going to cause you some headache with it getting caught up in your hooks all the time. And then finally, we're going to talk about fluorocarbon, straight fluorocarbon. When you throw straight fluorocarbon, anytime you're not worried about your line sinking, first of all. So you never want to throw straight fluorocarbon with poppers, ploppers, and walking baits, because it's going to pull the weight of the line's going to sink, and it's going to pull the nose of the bait down into the water and mess with the action of the bait. So straight fluorocarbon, you would use skipping light baits. I talked about earlier with, you know, spinning rods with a drop shot fluorocarbon to braid to fluorocarbon. If you're skipping these light baits with a spinning rod and you have braid on there and it gets old and soft, it's just going to cause you trouble. So straight fluorocarbon on skipping light baits, because it'll keep going, whereas that braid will fold up and cause trouble on you, like I said, on a spinning reel. And then you would use straight fluorocarbon for, you know, most flipping and pitching applications, especially clear water or pressured fish applications. And, you know, there's, you know, all different test line, and you know, you match the line to the situation. If you're fishing someplace where it's all, you know, 1.5 and 2 pound fish, you know, you can get away with 14 or 16 pound fluorocarbon. If you're fishing someplace where, you know, your next catch could be a 7 or 8 or 9 pounder, you know, you may want 20, 25 pound fluorocarbon on your rod. And then another time you would use straight fluorocarbon would be deep crankbaiting, because it's going to actually help your bait get deeper because fluorocarbon sinks. Or when you are throwing a suspending jerkbait, which I think the consensus is, and I believe, that a suspending jerkbait is good, but a slightly sinking jerkbait is even better. Just slightly sinking. So that you have a neutral buoyancy jerkbait and you put fluorocarbon on there, it's going to drag that bait down a little bit with it. So a suspending jerkbait would be a good application for straight fluorocarbon. So these are the three lines, the five different ways you can rig them up: braid to fluoro, straight braid, mono, straight fluoro, and then braid to mono, which covers most of the bases that you would need in order to understand when to use which line, when and where. And again, if you like my channel, please subscribe to my channel, hit the little like button and the little alert bell, and you'll get alerts to new videos coming up. Again, I appreciate you watching my channel, and stay tuned for more videos on all sorts of things bass fishing. Have a blessed day.